Hello guys, welcome to my channel. Today I will discuss about cell cycle checkpoints and regulation of maturation promoting factor or MPF in detail. To learn in detail about cell cycle and its phases, restriction point in detail, please watch my previous video. Link is provided in the description. So let's start. In the previous video, I have discussed about cell cycle and its phases and the controls like start and restriction point that regulate cell cycle progression in response to extracellular signals such as nutrients and growth factors. In most cells, this coordination between different phases of the cell cycle is dependent on a series of cell cycle checkpoints that prevent entry into the next phase of the cell cycle until the events of the preceding phase have been completed. Several cell cycle checkpoints called DNA damage checkpoints function to ensure that damaged DNA is not replicated and passed on to daughter cells. These checkpoints sense damaged or incompletely replicated DNA and coordinate further cell cycle progression with the completion of DNA replication or repair. DNA damage checkpoints function in G1, S and G2 phases of the cell cycle. Coming to the G1 checkpoint, arrest at the G1 checkpoint allows repair of any DNA damage that occurs before the cell enters S phase. Now, S checkpoint. The S checkpoint not only provides continual monitoring of the integrity of DNA to ensure that damaged DNA is repaired before it is replicated, but also provides a quality control monitor to promote that repair of any errors that occur during DNA replication, like incorporation of incorrect bases or incomplete replication of DNA segments. G2 checkpoint. The checkpoint in G2 prevents the initiation of mitosis if the cell contains DNA that has not been completely replicated or contains unrepaired lesions. Such damaged DNA activates a signaling pathway that leads to cell cycle arrest. Another important cell cycle checkpoint that maintains the integrity of the genome occurs toward the end of the mitosis. It is the spindle assembly checkpoint. This checkpoint monitors the alignment of chromosomes on the mitotic spindle, thus ensuring that a complete set of chromosomes is distributed accurately to the daughter cells. It checks whether all the kinetochores of the chromosomes are attached with the spindles. The failure of one or more chromosomes to align properly on the spindle causes mitosis to arrest at metaphase. I will discuss about the spindle assembly checkpoint in detail during my video on mitosis. Now let's understand cyclins and cyclin dependent kinases. Studies have revealed that cell cycle of all eukaryotes is controlled by a conserved set of protein kinases which are responsible for triggering the major cell cycle transitions. So what are cyclins? Cyclins are a family of regulatory proteins that control the progression of cell cycle. Cyclins activate cyclin-dependent kinases or CDKs which control cell cycle processes through phosphorylation. When a cyclin and CDK form a complex, the complex will bind to a target protein and modify it via phosphorylation. These proteins are called cyclins because their concentration varies in a cyclic fashion during the cell cycle. Here we can see that different cyclin concentrations increases and decreases in different phases of the cell cycle. So, what is cyclin dependent kinase? They are the families of protein kinases first discovered for their role in regulating the cell cycle. The CDK activation requires binding of specific cyclin. This is the X-ray crystallography picture of human CDK kinase protein. In higher eukaryotes, different members of these cyclin and CDK families control progression through distinct phases of the cell cycle. Progression from G1 to S is regulated by CDK4 and CDK6 and CDK2 in association with cyclin D and cyclin E's. The D-type cyclins, that is D1, D2 and D3, form complexes with CDK4 and 6 that play a critical role in progression through the restriction point in G1. Then cyclin E, that is E1 and E2, express, and CDK2 form complexes with cyclin E's that are required for the G1 to S transition and initiation of DNA synthesis. Then CDK2 with A2 type cyclins A1 and A2 form the complexes that are activated later in S phase and function through the G2 phase. Finally, initiation of mitosis and passage through M phase are controlled by CDK1 in complexes with B-type cyclins, that is B1, B2 and B3. It is also called maturation promoting factor or MPF. Activation of these cyclin CDK complexes are regulated by phosphorylation as well as synthesis and degradation of the cyclic protein cyclins. Another way these complexes are regulated are by the binding of CDK inhibitor proteins or CKIs. There are two families of CKIs. These are INK family inhibitors and CYPK family inhibitors. The INK family inhibitors bind to CDK4 and CDK6 and thus inhibit cell cycle progression at only G1 phase, while the CYPK family inhibitors bind to CDK2 and thus inhibit cell cycle in G1S and G2 phase. Now let's understand maturation promoting factor or MPF in detail. In 1983, Tim Hunt and his colleagues identified two proteins. These proteins displayed a periodic pattern of accumulation and degradation in sea urchin and clam embryos. They accumulate throughout interphase and are then rapidly degraded towards the end of mitosis. Hunt called these proteins cyclins, that is cyclin A and cyclin B, and suggested that they might function to induce mitosis by periodically forming and degrading. Later it was discovered that in MPF, this cyclin B is the regulatory subunit which regulates the activation of MPF. Coming to the structure of MPF, MPF has two subunits. These are cyclin B and CDK1. Cyclin B is the regulatory subunit required for catalytic activity of the CDK1 protein kinase. This supports the fact that only in presence of cyclin, MPF is active. The cyclin level rises throughout the interphase and during the G2 phase, this cyclin B forms complex with the ever-present CDK1. But in G2 phase, this cyclin B CDK1 complex remains inactive. So let's understand the regulation of MPF. During the G2 phase of interphase, the cyclin B forms complex with the CDK1. After the complex formation, the CDK1 undergoes phosphorylation at two critical regulatory regions. One is at the threonine 161 position, which is required for CDK1 kinase activity, and the second one is at the tyrosine 15 and threonine 14. Phosphorylation at tyrosine 15 inhibits CDK1 activity and leads to the accumulation of inactive cyclin B CDK1 complexes throughout the G2. So this tyrosine 15 is the inhibitory phosphorylation region. Phosphorylation at tyrosine 15 is catalyzed by a protein kinase called V1. The G2 to M transition is brought about by the activation of the cyclin B CDK1 complex or MPF by a protein phosphatase called CDC25. Phosphatases are enzymes that remove phosphate from a substrate. This phosphatase dephosphorylates the inhibitory phosphorylation of threonine 14 and tyrosine 15. Once the MPF becomes activated, the CDK1 protein kinase phosphorylates a variety of target proteins that initiate the events of M phase. CDK1 activity later also triggers the degradation of cyclin B, which occurs as a result of ubiquitin-mediated proteolysis. An ubiquitin ligase called anaphase promoting complex or APC activated by MPF ubiquitinates the cyclin B. As a result, CDK1 becomes inactivated. This leads the cell to exit mitosis, undergo cytokinesis, and again enter into the interphase. During interphase, again the cyclin B protein accumulates, and in G2 phase, it again forms complex with CDK1, leading to the formation of MPF again. So, today I have discussed about the cell cycle checkpoints, defined cyclins and CDKs that regulate the cell cycle, and the structure and regulation of maturation promoting factor MPF in details. In my next video, I will discuss about role of growth factors in cell cycle, RBE2F, DNA damage checkpoints, ATM, ATR in detail. To learn in detail about cell cycle and its phases and restriction point in detail, please watch my previous video, link provided in the description. In the meantime, don't forget to like and share my videos and also subscribe to my channel. Thank you, stay home, stay safe, and study online.